Before going into the break, we have discussed some initial part of the mechanics. I discussed about kinematics, velocity displacement, as well as momentum, right? So अभी कुछ देर पहले हमने सब चीजें discuss की थी, right? So we'll continue with that and finish it up mechanics in this session. So I am, you know, sticking only to those parts which are important for exam, you know, quite basic ones. We'll not go into the details because in this 1 hour of session, the complete 1 hour of mechanics session, we have to cover each and everything. Along with some of the MCQ assignment that we'll cover after finishing this, right? So I will take around 20 minutes to finish it off. So हमने basic चीजें पहले भी discuss कर दिया तुम्हें. So projectiles वगैरह मैंने discuss कर दिया. मैंने body is thrown upward, vertically upward, that I have already explained, which is actually important, right? So starting with the Newton's law. So I will keep the things relevant. So first law talks about inertia, right? So inertia is the tendency of the body, or even the state of the body. In which it remains in a state of rest, motion, or in the steady direction until and unless some force is exerted, right? So जब तक कोई external force लगा हो, वो अपनी state में वैसे ही रहती है, right? So inertia is related to mass. That means you can say that higher the mass, that means inertia will be more. So for example, you know, it will be difficult to move a heavier object in comparison to a lighter object, right? आप ट्रक को मूव करना मुश्किल है, उसी तरह उसको स्टॉप करना भी मुश्किल है. सो इनर्शिया ऑफ रेस्ट, इनर्शिया ऑफ मोशन, इनर्शिया ऑफ डायरेक्शन. इवन टू चेंज द डायरेक्शन यू नीड सम एक्सटर्नल फोर्स. सो फर्स्ट लॉ टॉक्स अबाउट इनर्शिया. इनर्शिया इज रिलेटेड टू मास, हेंस वी जनरली से इनर्शियल मास, राइट? सम एग्जांपल्स व्हिच आर क्वाइट कॉमन, यू माइट हैव डन थ्रू रेस्ट, जैसे आप पढ़ते हो व्हेन द बस सडनली स्टार्ट्स, यू आर थ्रोन बैकवर्ड, राइट? आप जैसे स्टॉप करते हो, यू आर थ्रोन फॉरवर्ड, बिकॉज द लोअर बॉडी वॉज इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द बस, विद द बस विच वॉज इन मोशन. लेट सपोज, सो सडनली इफ द ब्रेक इज अप्लाइड, योर लोअर बॉडी कम्स टू रेस्ट, बट अपर बॉडी इज स्टिल इन मोशन. दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन, डस्टिंग ऑफ द कोड, राइट? सो द क्वेश्चन आस्किंग यूपीएससी, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फर्स्ट लॉ, और दे विल गिव यू दैट, यू नो, दिस एग्जाम्पल इज एक्सप्लेन बाय फर्स्ट लॉ, सेकंड लॉ, थर्ड लॉ, राइट? नन ऑफ दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन. So coming to second law statement says that the net external force acting on a body is equal to rate of change in momentum. Rate of change in momentum, I already told you, rate matlab divided by time. So when you say rate of change in momentum, that means delta p by d, change in momentum by time. What is momentum? We discussed yesterday. Momentum is mass into velocity. That means change in momentum is mass final velocity minus initial velocity by time, right? So this will give you F is equal to ma. So F is equal to ma is actually the inference of Newton's second law. Okay, so the simple question can be that if a 10 newton force is applied on a body of mass 2 kg, what is the acceleration? In fact, I have seen that in some PCS exam they have asked acceleration, unit of acceleration, that is meter per second. It's quite common. You don't need to remember. I hope I don't need to tell you what is the unit of force, that is newton, right? SI units, right? So ye sab cheeze yaad rakhna. So SI unit of force is newton and CGS unit is dyne, dyne, right? 1 न्यूटन इज इक्वल टू 10 टू द पावर 5 dyne. ये सब बहुत बेसिक चीजें हैं जो आपको आई थिंक पहले से पता होनी चाहिए, राइट? बट एक बार सीरियस में दे हैव आस्क्ड दिस थिंग. नाउ रिलेटिंग टू दिस, यू नो, वी कैन हैव सम थ्योरेटिकल डिस्कशन. आई थिंक वन पार्ट आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, दैट व्हेनेवर आई से दैट बॉडी इज इन इक्विलिब्रियम. सो बॉडी इक्विलिब्रियम का मतलब क्या है? जैसे आपको कहा जाए द बॉडी वॉज इन इक्विलिब्रियम, दैट मीन्स नेट फोर्स इज जीरो. आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन टू यू इन द फर्स्ट सेशन दैट नेट फोर्स मतलब आपके पास कम से कम, यू नो, मे बी 3 force, 4 force, 5 force, you know, there are 5-6 forces, but the net is 0. If net force is 0, that means net acceleration is 0, because we discussed F is equal to ma. So if F is 0, that means A, net acceleration is 0. What is the meaning of net acceleration 0? Body may be at rest or may be going with constant speed, right? So there are two possible cases. So if they say that body must be at rest, that is wrong. It may be at rest, right? And balanced and equilibrium. Balanced force means, you know, same case as that of equilibrium. Balanced force is acting on a body, that means the net is zero, right? Now one question asked in CDS exam was, what is the minimum number of force required to keep the body in equilibrium, right? So answer was 1, 2, 3, 4 options, right? So let's suppose discuss it. So if a body is, right now I am holding this object, let's suppose mg is acting downwards while I am applying force to, you know, counter this mg. So there are two forces applied. So if you say that, let's suppose a simple body in air, nobody is holding it. So that means mg is acting on it, which makes it to come down, right? So if mg is only force which is acting on it, it will come down. So If one force acts on your body, body can never be in equilibrium, right? So what is the minimum number of force required? 2. It may be 3, it may be 4, but there was minimum. So answer is 2. The minimum number of force required to keep the body in equilibrium is 2. Third law, if we talk about, let's suppose a block of mass, a body of mass M kept over a surface. So Mg is acting downward while a normal reaction acts upward. That's why it is at rest, or you can say this is an equilibrium. So in equilibrium, upward force is equal to downward force, right? Due to which it is in equilibrium actually, right? So if you know Mg was more than normal reaction, it would have come down. Okay. So it talks about action reaction pair. One thing what you need to remember about action reaction pair is that, so action and reaction, they are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction, right? Mg was acting downwards while normal reaction was acting upward. So values are same, then maybe 100 newton downward, 100 newton upward, but direction is opposite. So the second thing, action reaction acts on different bodies. So if I say action is on the table, normal reaction is on the block, right? So action reaction are equal in magnitude but they act on different objects. So a different word is important. This has been asked already in UPSC exam. Conservation of momentum theorem, right, is anyhow related to the second law. We say that if net external force is zero, so if net external force is zero, that means delta by P by T is zero. It means ki P is constant, right? So momentum of a system matlab I'm talking about as a whole. You can say that, let's suppose bullet plus gun system, right? So if you fire up the bullet will go ahead while the gun will recoil back. Why? Because due to conservation of momentum. You can also relate it to the third law, action reaction kind of thing, right? So gun plus bullet was a system. Okay, so if you find a word in the question like isolated system, by default means, you know, you don't have any contact with external force, that means net external force is zero. So if the statement said momentum is conserved in isolated system, that means it is correct, right? So important conservation of momentum laws are also important. You can see, you know, gun plus a you know, explosion of the bomb, right? So let's suppose bomb was initially at rest, it explodes into 2, 3, 5, right? So initial momentum was zero, so the net sum of all the parts, net vector sum of all the parts of the momentum will be zero, right? Explosion of the bomb. There are numerous examples you can get from the options, right? So this was all about that Newton's second law, right? In theoretical points, I would like to state that, let's suppose a simple case when, ek example bataunga aapko numericals ke liye, just for the, let's suppose a person is hanging to a rope, or you can say a body is hanging to a rope like this, right? So of total mass M, so you know this block will try to come down. Why? Because Mg is acting downward, right? So if Mg is acting downward, the rope will try to resist, right? Because it is tight, so tension will try to balance this Mg. So if this is at rest, or you can say equilibrium, T is equal to Mg like this. So tension was equal to Mg, tension is force, tension unit will be Newton. Tension in the what? Tension in the string, right? Now let's suppose we have a case when we have a person who is trying to climb the rope, right, with some acceleration at upward, maybe downward, right? That is depend upon the case. So here you can say the Mg is acting downward, tension will be upward. Now the complete system is going upward with acceleration A. So can I say what is the net force? Net force on this is T minus Mg. Why I have taken T on the left side? Because of course if T is more, then only that body will move upward. So T minus Mg, net force is equal to mass into acceleration. That means you will get tension in the rope will be M times G plus A, which is greater than Mg. So can I conclude that if the body is climbing up with some acceleration, the tension in the rope will increase? Yes. If the body is climbing up with constant velocity, tension will remain still Mg. Why? Because constant velocity means acceleration is zero. So the, you know, even if you are hanging to a rope, or you are going up with constant velocity, or maybe you are coming down with constant velocity, acceleration is zero in all the three cases, and tension will remain equal to Mg. So when you go up, the same question can be asked in case of lift. If the lift is accelerating upward, what is the apparent weight? So in that case, you can say the apparent weight, that is N is equal to M times bracket G plus A. When it is coming downward, in the same case, you can write, you know, if the system is coming downward, tension upward, that is it, you can write Mg minus T is equal to Ma. So T is equal to M times G minus A. So it gives me information that it is greater than Mg. So when the lift is coming down with some acceleration, the person will feel less weight. When the lift is going up with acceleration, the person will feel that weight is increased. Right, in case whether the lift is going constant velocity downward, or maybe with constant velocity upward, or maybe at rest, the weight of the person will be, apparent weight of the person, that is weight experienced by the person, will be equal to real weight, right? So ये important है, आप याद रखना. So ये दोनों केस आप याद रखना. वैसे तो this question was asked in NDA, but NDA physics is also of class 10th level, so they ask 1-2 some typical question. In case if they ask, you can solve it, you will have an edge. Next, coming to the circular motion, we have two different kinds of circular motion. What exactly is circular motion? A body of mass m moving in a circular track with some velocity in a circular track of radius r, right? It's a kind of circular motion. So aap dekho, so there can be two possible cases, right? I am running in a circular path with constant speed, 2 meter per second, 3 meter per second, aisa kuch, right? So agar main lagatar, you know, 2 meter per second se move kar raha hu, my speed is constant but my direction is changing at each and every instant of time, right? So the case of circular motion in which your speed is constant, you are moving with uniform speed, that is called uniform circular motion. So this UCM stands for uniform circular motion, right? Speed constant, but since your direction is changing, velocity will never be constant. In fact, velocity will never be constant in any case of circular motion. I discussed it yesterday also. Now since your speed is constant, kinetic energy will also remain constant, half m speed square, right? Next, if kinetic energy is constant, the change in kinetic energy in case of uniform circular motion will be zero. Now we have one theorem called as work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. Work done by all the forces is equal to change in kinetic energy of system. So if kinetic energy of the system does not change, that is kinetic energy of system, change in kinetic energy is zero, it means that net work done by all the forces acting on the body is zero, right? So you know, when the body of mass m moving with some velocity is in circular motion, there must be some force which is, you know, keeping that body in circular motion, and that force is called centripetal force, and the value of that centripetal force is mv square by r. So anyhow, you can say that centripetal force is inversely proportional to radius, right? Directly proportional to speed. So acceleration, centripetal acceleration, that you can compare this with f is equal to ma, and you can find that acceleration, centripetal acceleration, can be written as v square by r. So in serious question, they have asked the graph of centripetal acceleration with respect to r. So a is equal to v square by r, that means, you know, anything when it is inversely proportional, the graph will be hyperbolic in nature, right? So ye points aap likh lena, this is important actually. So this can help you in MCQs. So there are numerous points which I mentioned, right? Next, non-uniform circular motion. The second case in which if I am in a circular track with right now velocity 2 meter per second, the next second my velocity may be 1.5, in the very next it may be 3. That means my speed is not constant. This kind of circular motion is called non-uniform circular motion. Since the speed is not constant here, that means kinetic energy will not be constant, right? So change in kinetic energy will also not be zero, and hence work done in this case will not be zero. That means there is some amount of work done in case of NUCM, non-uniform circular motion. Now if they talk about momentum, momentum is mass into velocity, we discussed yesterday also, and here the direction changes, that means momentum will always keep on changing in case of circular or elliptical path, right? So in case of non-uniform circular motion, we have two kinds of acceleration, centripetal and tangential. But in uniform circular motion, we have only one kind of acceleration, that is centripetal. Centripetal acceleration always acts inwards, that is towards the center, and its value is v square by r. While the tangential acceleration is along the tangent, right, at, right, along the tangent, its value is given by rate of change in the magnitude of velocity, dv by dt. So these formulas are not important, but remember that rate of change in the linear velocity is actually given by tangential acceleration. Two kinds of acceleration in case of NUCM, right? So examples of the circular motion, you can say bending of the cyclist along the turn, right? There is a maximum velocity limit around a circular turn, right? When you go in hilly areas, they call it adhiktam gati sima, maximum speed limit, to keep you on the safe side, right? So some examples you should keep in mind, why does a cyclist bend, right? To keep himself safe, that he won't get na jaye. वो नॉर्मल का कंपोनेंट उसके वेट को बैलेंस करता है, एंड सम कंपोनेंट ऑफ द नॉर्मल प्रोवाइड्स द नेसेसरी सेंट्रीपिटल एक्सेलरेशन. व्हाई डू वी डू बैंकिंग ऑफ द रोड, सम यू नो सम पार्ट ऑफ द रोड्स इज एलिवेटेड इन सर्कुलर ट्रैक, फ्लाईओवर वगैरह में, रीजन, राइट, टू अवॉइड डिपेंडेंसी ऑन द फ्रिक्शन, राइट. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट सर्कुलर मोशन. ग्राफ्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट, फैक्ट्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट. कमिंग टू द एनर्जी पार्ट, काइनेटिक एंड पोटेंशियल एनर्जी, एवरीबडी नोज हाफ एम इनटू स्पीड का स्क्वायर. Potential is mgh, right? So I will share one example. Let's suppose right now a body is at position, you know, A, which is lying at from the ground 10 meter height. Okay, so what is the energy of this body? Potential energy will be mg into 10. Kinetic energy, since it is at rest, is zero. So what is the total energy at position A? So total energy at position A is mg into 10. So I will just draw again. ये आपकी बॉडी है, मास m, दिस हाइट इज टोटल 10. सो आई कैन से एट पोजिशन ए पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज mg into 10, गिवन दैट हाइट इज 10. तो काइनेटिक एनर्जी वॉज जीरो बिकॉज इट वॉज अ डस्ट. नाउ लेट सपोज की आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट सम अदर पोजिशन विच इज लाइंग एट अ डिस्टेंस 4 मीटर फ्रॉम द टॉप. सो बाय डिफॉल्ट इट मीन्स 6 मीटर फ्रॉम द बॉटम. सो यू कैन राइट पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एट बी एज mg into 6 mg. So if I ask you what is the kinetic energy right now at position B, so you should write, look, total energy of the system remains constant, total mechanical energy I am talking, right, kinetic plus potential, total work 10 mg, out of which at position B the potential is 6 mg, that means the rest of the energy is in the form of kinetic. So initially the kinetic energy was 0 at the top, now it has increased up to 4 mg. So you can see what is happening from A to B. Kinetic energy is increasing while potential is decreasing. So this kind of statements are there in question CDS 12016. This was the question asked, right? What is happening? Right? Same question the asked in CDS 2015 was during a swing, right? The jhula wala aapka case hai. If the swing goes from lower to higher point, which of the following is correct, right? So as you know, if it goes from lower to higher point, what will happen? Speed will slow down. That means kinetic energy will decrease. But potential energy will increase, and at any position throughout, kinetic plus potential sum will be constant. Why? Because conservation of energy principle. Now, if I ask, now second form of the question that can be asked, right, the ratio of kinetic energy at B with respect to total energy. So kinetic energy was 4 mg, total energy was 10 mg, so it is 4/10, that is 2/5. So the statement can be of the form, kinetic energy at B was 2/5 of the total energy. Yes. They can also ask you kinetic energy at B upon potential energy of B. So they can say you kinetic energy is 4/6. You can say K by B is equal to 4/6. So can I say that kinetic energy is to potential energy at point B was 2/3. Okay. So at position, let's suppose C, that is ground, right? Here the complete energy will be in the form of kinetic, that is 10 mg, and potential energy will become 0. You can see at each and every instant the sum of total energy is constant. This is what actually we say. Conservation of energy principle. What is the unit of energy? Joules. So energy is, unit is joules, right? 1 joule is equal to how much ergs? Joule is SI unit and ergs is CGS unit. So 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power 7 ergs. Remember this, right? 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power 7 ergs. Energy is a scalar quantity, work is a scalar quantity. They don't have direction. Any kind of energy, whether electrical, mechanical, kuch bhi ho, all are scalar, they have the same unit. Coming to the next part, that is work. Right, so question had been asked from this, so I will just share a brief about work. I hope you have written this. So work is basically defined as, it's a scalar quantity defined as the dot product of force and displacement, that is magnitude of force A dot B is magnitude of displacement and cos theta. Right, so work can be positive work, can be negative work, can be zero work. So the most common is zero work, which is generally asked in exam, is what will be the condition for the zero work, right? So one of the case which will be asked is when cos theta is zero. That means cos theta zero hoegi kab when theta is 90. That means I can say if force acting on a body is perpendicular to the direction, the if force acting on a body is perpendicular to the displacement. Let's suppose I'm holding this marker, right, and moving like this. Okay. So force acting on it, right? If I ask you, what is the work done due to gravity? Gravity, what was gravity doing here? It was, you know, applying a force mg downward. And what was the displacement of the body along the perpendicular direction? So can I conclude that angle between this displacement and the force was 90 degrees? So the work done by gravity was 90. Work done by me. So I was holding this object, right, like this. My force was upward if I am holding like this. Okay. But the displacement was in the horizontal direction. Since F and S are in perpendicular to each other, so you can say that work done is zero. Right? So this is important. Work done will be positive when cos theta is positive, and cos theta will be positive when theta is acute angle. Right? So example aap le lo, jaise ye. This is F. Right? If the object is moving like this. So angle between force and displacement is acute. So here the work done will be positive. Right? If we have like work done by friction. Right, so work done by friction kya hota hai, jaise aap maan lo, you know, you have applied brakes in the car, but still it is moving ahead for some distance, right? So force of friction was trying to stop it, that is resistive force, but the body went ahead. So the force of friction is backward, but the motion was forward. So angle is 180 degree, even mathematics is cos 180 is minus 1, right? So work done by friction is negative in nature here, right? When a ball, when let's suppose that you drop a, you know, any object in air or maybe liquid, the resistive force, the viscosity force, the air drag is acting upward, the body comes downward. In this case, work done by the drag is negative. Okay, right. I already discussed work energy theorem, that work done by all the forces. All the force matlab internal, external, conservative, non-conservative. Conservative force does not depend upon the path taken, while non-conservative force depends upon the path taken. Just keep in mind. So this was about work. Right. If you ask me what is the energy stored in the spring, right? If you take up a spring and stretch it up, or maybe you compress it up. So let's suppose you have a spring here, right? Right. If force F is applied on a spring, right? If you compress up a spring by, let's suppose, So initial, this was the initial position. This is final position. So length has been extended by X. So it is found that if you stretch this string, the spring will try to regain back its original position by force, which is actually proportional to the negative of displacement. So force is proportional to negative of displacement here. This is actually the condition of simple harmonic motion, right? SHM, oscillations mein padhte hain. Now it becomes F is equal to minus kx, where k is called spring constant. The spring constant depends upon material of the spring. Material of the spring as well as geometry. Geometry matlab you can say length of the spring. Right? This question was asked in CDS 2016. Spring constant depends upon. Okay. So from here I can also say F is equal to, or you can say F by X magnitude is K. So if I ask you what is the unit of a spring constant, force is Newton, X is length, that is Newton per meter. Right? So what is the energy stored in a stretched string? The energy in a stretched or maybe compressed spring is given by half kx square. That means energy is directly proportional to the compression or elongation square. So if the graph was u versus x, it will be parabolic, because yesterday we discussed whenever we have two variables, one of them is power 2, it will be a kind of parabola. Right? So if we have the energy stored, because maybe questions can be asked that if the spring is stretched by 2 cm, the energy was u. Now what is the energy stored if the spring is stressed by double, initial, if it is stressed by 2x, the u is proportional to x square. Now if you change the x to 2x, it will become u by u dash is equal to this one, u upon u dash is equal to 1/4, that means u dash is equal to 4 times u, energy will become double. So this kind of relative, comparative type questions are generally asked in UPSC. They will not ask much calculation, but one step calculation ratio type can definitely be there in the paper. So you should be ready with that. So coming to the power. So power actually means rate of work done. That means work by time. Since work and energy have the same unit, you can say rate of energy production, rate of heat production, all have the same unit. Rate of change in kinetic energy, right? Because everything in the denominator has the unit joules. So can I say that unit of power is joule per second, which is also commonly called as watt, right? So the SI unit of the power is watt. In general, 1 megawatt means mega stands for 10 to the power 6 watt, kilowatt means 10 to the power 3 watt. Now, generally you see that, the electricity bills, right, majority power is same in electricity also. The electricity bills are there, that is in terms of some units, right? So we have one popular unit, just say, if I say 1 kilowatt hour, what does this mean? 1 kilo matlab 10 to the power 3, watt matlab 1 joule per second, and hours matlab 3600 seconds. So second and second cancel, so finally I am left with 3.6 into 10 to the power 6. Joules, right? So kilowatt hour is the unit of energy. It's not the unit of watt. This is universal circadian question. This question had been asked at least 7-8 times in CDS, NDA, CAPF. Each and every circadian exam has already asked this question. 2016, this question was also asked. The question was the unit of mechanical power is. So any kind of power will have unit watt only, whether it is mechanical, electrical, or like anything. right? So any kind of power can be mentioned in terms of kilowatt hour. So kilowatt hour is the unit of energy, not power. What is the unit of power? Kilowatt is the unit of power, but kilowatt hour, that means you are multiplying power with time, right? So since power is equal to work by time, so power into time will be work, right? So if the question says that, you know, kilowatt hour is the unit of, options are, you know, options are energy, heat, kinetic energy, which of the following are correct? All three are correct, right? Because all three can be explained in terms of joules. So what into time, power into time is actually something joules. That joule can be heat, energy, you know, work, maybe potential energy, maybe light energy, anything. Okay, now one more thing, this is, if you cram, those who are not from the science background, if you cram it like this, now aisa zaruri nahi ki the same option will be there in the paper. They can also give you 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3600 into 10 raised to the power 3 joules, right? That means aise bhi ho sakta hai 3600 kilo joules. So you should read down the options carefully. Now this was also the question asked in CDS 1, I think 2017. 1 kilowatt hour is equal to. So this term was not in the option, but 3600 kilojoule was the option. Right? So some chote chote terms you can say, you know, dyne, ergs, this you are able to resolve. Ye zaruri hai. Otherwise, you know, this kind of silly mistakes will be actually lethal for your exam, for performance. Right? So this is about power. Okay. Next, the last topic is collision. Last topic is collision. So in collision, what we study majority is elastic and inelastic collision. So in any type of collision, momentum is always conserved. Momentum is conserved. What does this mean? Initial momentum of the system, net initial momentum of the system is equal to net final momentum. Chahe elastic ho, chahe inelastic ho, the momentum of the system will remain conserved. Right? Now what does it differentiate between this elastic and inelastic is, in elastic collision, total kinetic energy of system, right? Let's suppose two bodies are colliding, like m1 idhar se aa rahi hai with velocity v1, m2 idhar se aa rahi hai v2 se, right? So initial momentum is m1 v1 minus m2 v2, why? Because we have to take care of the minus also, because they are in the opposite direction. If they are in the same direction, right, two cars going in the same way and second car collides with the first one from back side, so that m1 v1 plus m2 v2, why? Because they are in the same direction. Momentum is a vector quantity. Right. So if I say what is the total initial kinetic energy, half mv1 square plus half m2v2 square. Why not minus? Because kinetic energy is scalar quantity, right? So total energy of the system before collision is equal to total kinetic energy of the system after collision, right? But in elastic collision, in case of inelastic collision, total kinetic energy is not conserved. Matlab there is some loss of kinetic energy. There is some loss of kinetic energy. There is some loss in kinetic energy during collision, right? Now there is a term called as perfectly inelastic collision. Perfectly inelastic collision. Right? It means, example se samjho aap, let's suppose we have a sandbag, a bullet is fired, right? Bullet of mass m1, sandbag is m2. Right? What will happen? It's given that bullet is fired with some velocity v such that bullet gets embedded into it. Right? So this is m plus, the total mass is now m plus m, m1 plus m2. Now they will move with some common velocity. So whenever, you know, two bodies collide such that one of them gets embedded into it or clinches to it, or such that they move together after collision, that case is called perfectly inelastic collision. Right? So jab bhi question mein aisa hint ho, the two bodies collided and the first one gets stick to the first one. Let's say, if your car is going and somebody jumps on the car suddenly, now he's part of the car, he's part of the car in the system. Right? They both will move with the common velocity. So this is an example of perfectly inelastic collision. Right, one more thing.